I've mentioned in past videos the importance of getting kids involved in freestyle music. And in this video, we're gonna dive a little deeper into that subject. You ready? So let's go. Hey, what's up, freestylers? Latif here, exploring with you the voice, sound, and culture of freestyle music. And every week on this channel, we discuss ways that we, as a freestyle music community, can recognize, define, and nurture the culture that we know lies within the genre. We'll also be talking with not only different artists and other freestyle personnel, but also some of those incredible fans in search of ideas that can help us resurrect the genre back to the way we remember it. Now, if you're new to this channel and feel like this is something that you can get down with, do me a favor and smash that like button. And if you click subscribe and the little bell beside it, every time I upload a new video, you'll be the first to know. I'd like to start off this video with a bit of a shout out. A shout out to all the freestyle artists, both established and non. Those who have continued to hustle, releasing new music and performing everywhere. To all those writers who haven't put down their pen in over 20 years. And to the background dancers who till this day still manage to keep shit exciting. To all the producers, managers, promoters, and agents who keep this freestyle machine well oiled. And to all the DJs. Damn. What would we have done without you? Do what we do because we love it, and we don't see it ending anytime soon. With that said, I'd like to open up the gates, and with your help, I'd like to invite the kids in, and I'll tell you why. In the late 80s, early 90s, style music began to lose its momentum until this little girl popped up, and she went by the name of Little Susie. And now, today, over 30 years later, people still try to figure out what is it about Little Susie. Not only is she still one of the most requested in the genre, she also commands one of the highest fees for a solo freestyle artist. And having been so young, she, without even realizing it, introduced this genre to a whole other generation. And yes, she's still considered freestyle's youngest living legend. I remember after the shows coming outside and seeing these long lines of kids who couldn't get in because they were too young. They wanted to get autographs and take pictures. Susie made sure she took care of everybody. The funny thing about it, a lot of those kids were even older than her. So what happened? What was it that made her blow up so early? Well, being a young novelty act didn't hurt. But anyone who's seen her perform back in the days as a little girl will definitely admit the charisma that she portrayed on stage made her seem 10 feet tall. That, along with some great writing, great productions, and a great team behind her, Susie was destined for success, and that she enjoyed for over 30 years. Now, I'm sorry, this video isn't about Little Susie. It's about her situation and how it worked in her favor. And the fact that I was there, what I saw was real, and I just wanna share it. I like to do whatever I possibly can to help introduce a new generation to the genre. But I need your help. I need your help finding them. Now, before we go any further, I need to give one more shout out, if you don't mind. And this one is to another young lady who is not only extremely cute, but also very talented. And she goes by the name of Lily Rose. Now, most of you who are watching this should know who she is, but for those who don't, she is the young daughter of freestyle artists Willie Valentin and Cynthia Figueroa, both of Artistic Records. Now, I've been sitting back and checking them out for a while, and honestly, I think they got this. You know, the only advice I would say at this point would be consistency and patience. You're doing a great job, guys. And Lily, listen, you're gonna be a star, girl, so keep up the great work. Now, Lily just filmed her first music video, so I put the link down below. Make sure you check that out, and please show us some love. And now back to the topic, which is introducing the kids to the freestyle music genre. And with the examples of Little Susie and now Lily Rose, come on, man, it's a great fit. So look, if you have a child in your family who's extremely talented, or at the very least shows interest in being an artist, I'll tell you right now, freestyle music might actually be that golden doorway. Look, it's clean music with family-friendly lyrics. We probably have more writers and producers than any other genre. And as far as club and concert events, well, those things are all over the place. So let's say you have a kid that's really talented or, you know, shows the desire to be a singer. And you agree with me that freestyle music might actually be the perfect first step. My first advice would be to introduce them to the genre, to the music. They can listen to just about anything because the music is uncensored. In fact, you'll probably never even run across anything that might be considered inappropriate. Go on YouTube with them and start to let them check out some of the more professionally made videos. And if it moves them, let them consume as much as they possibly can. You know when they're really feeling it, when they start walking around the house singing Take Me In Your Arms and Inside Outside. The reason why I say start with the A-list is because there's a good chance that those are the ones that moved you into becoming a fan. Trust me, in time they'll develop their own ear and they'll even start listening to songs that you wouldn't even consider. But I still stand firm in telling you to start with the more established and successful artists because they have already proven themselves to the masses. Now, without getting too deep into the business, and I would like to mention one thing that I'm usually asked is, Latif, should we allow others to manage our kids? And the answer to that is 100% hell the fuck no. But at the same time, and for the sake of your kids, I will tell you this. You need to learn the business. You don't have to be a pro, but it's important to understand the vocabulary and how the system works. Look, we're in the information age. We have Google, we can order books online, and YouTube is full of tutorials. So take advantage. And for your kids' sake, learn the business. Now, don't go making this a job for them. Your first priority is their happiness. The moment they stop being happy about doing it, it's important that you pull back. Look, this could be an incredible experience for your kids, or it could be a nightmare. Don't make it a nightmare. Don't take away their playtime. Don't keep them from their friends. Don't make them practice hours upon hours. Let them first be kids, and I promise you that not only will they become incredible artists, but they'll also become incredible human beings. I have a dream, and that is to see a new generation of freestyle artists take over the genre. Look, if you guys have any questions about anything that I just spoke about, please put it in the comments below. Maybe we can start a dialogue among ourselves. So here's a question for you. Do you feel that by introducing kids to freestyle that we can bring new life to the genre? Your answer to this question will become the springboard to many discussions about this topic. And eventually, and only with your help, will we finally discover the voice, sound, and culture of freestyle music. Hey, I really appreciate you watching this video, and if it made any kind of sense to you, that thumbs up will let me know. And if you click subscribe and the little bell beside it, every time I upload a new video, you'll be the first to know. My name is Latif Mercado, and until next time, keep it real, keep it peace, and remember, freestyle for life!